Hey, what's up? Richie here from Breakthrough Studios and Richie's YouTube channel. I noticed that there aren't any in-depth professional tutorials on ArmA Video Making, so I am starting a series titled Professional Video Making in ArmA 2. This may or may not work in ArmA 3, maybe they changed something, I don't know, I haven't tried ArmA 3 because I mainly do videos in ArmA 2. So, if you've seen DayZ Origins mod trailers 1.5, 1.76, 1.77, I'm mainly a guy behind them. Of course, 1.77 was later edited by other people, which totally ruined the trailer, but you can see the camera work is still mine. So without further ado, let's get into making some videos. Now, before you start anything, you need to configure your game for maximum potential. You could just jump right into it, but that wouldn't be optimal, and you may run into some problems during production. So, the first thing I will configure will be the launch parameters, and you do this by going to your ArmA 2 Operation Arrowhead root directory. I am using a Steam version of ArmA, so it is installed in custom directory, so yours will be different, and yours may be in program files or anywhere else. Mine is located in D, Games, Steam, Steam Apps, Common, ArmA 2 Operation Arrowhead. There are a few ways to set launch parameters, but my method of choice is doing a batch file, mainly because it can be edited in any text editor, and I am really used to DOS. You could set launch parameters in Shortcut or even Steam, but the way I do this will launch the game independently of Steam, and I will be able to add more stuff to the launch file should I need to. So, the first thing you do is create a new text document. This is a little bit off screen for you, so let me just do this again. Yeah, here we go. You create a new text document, and you name it however you like. I like putting an underscore in front of my batch files to put them up in the alphabetical order. And let's call this, for example, launch. And don't forget to change the extension to BAT. And it will ask if you want to change. Yes, of course, you'd want to do that. Please note that if you have hide extensions for known file types enabled in folder options, which is enabled by default, you will not be able to rename the file to .bat. You will need to open Notepad and save file from there by selecting all file types and etc. But I'm sure you will figure that out, just Google it. And also, you should enable file extensions because, to tell you the truth, files without extensions just look plain ugly and you run into problems oftenly. So, anyway, open your batch file in text editor of your choice. Mine is Notepad++. Here you can see the file is empty and you start by typing start, and this is to just unhook the ArmA executable from command prompt, and then you type your executable name, which is ArmA2OA.exe. Next, you need to set the launch parameters, and launch parameters, depending on what you want to achieve, may be a little bit different, but I want to use combined operations, which is ArmA 2 and ArmA 2 Operation Arrowhead combined. And to do this, I need to set the mod directory of ArmA 2. So you go by writing quotes and you write in between quotes minus mod equals. And now you have to type the path to your ArmA 2 root folder, which in my case is /game/Steam/Steam Apps/Common/ArmA 2. So this is my path to ArmA 2. Yours will be different because I am using I'm using other drive than C, and I have custom folders and everything. Then you go by typing a semicolon, type expansion, semicolon, CA, and expansion is just a folder inside Operation Arrowhead root folder, which you can see right here. And CA is another folder which should be here, but well, I don't know, you just need this. You may be good to go right now, but I just like to maximize my game potential and setting other things. I like typing no splash, and what this does, it disables the Bohemia Interactive logos in the game start, where you have those fading logos, ArmA 2, Bohemia Interactive, everything. This parameter disables them. And next, I recommend setting game to windowed mode. You do this by typing minus window. As I said, I recommend to do this because you will be doing a lot of alt tabbing and task switching during your production. And then I set max VRAM, which is max video RAM, and I set this to 2047, which is the max value, and if you go any higher, this may cause problems with your game. So 2047 is the maximum value, and also max mem equals 2047, which is also max value, and you cannot go any higher than that. And the next parameter is CPU count. I'm using an 8-core machine, so I have 8 cores for me, and I like reserving 1 core for other tasks, so I type equals 7 to set 7 cores for the game. Next, you go by typing X threads, and what X threads are, this means extra threads, and this just dedicates certain cores to certain tasks in game rendering, and it is a bit flag value. And without going too technical, you should use 3 for 2 core machine and 7 for 4 core machine. Well, I have 8 core machine, so I'm just going to use 7, which is again the max value. And the last thing I like to add is show script errors, and this was enabled by default in Operation Flashpoint, and it just showed where you have script errors, but they disabled it in ArmA. And if your script doesn't work, chances are you have some errors in your script, and this parameter just lets you see where you have those errors. And the last thing I add to my batch file is exit, just for a good measure to exit the command prompt. Well, it will exit automatically, but you never know, so exit doesn't hurt. Now save your file and don't launch the game just yet. There are a few more things you will have to configure. Okay, next I will be configuring game CFG file found under documents ArmA 2, which you can see here. And the file is arma2oa.cfg. And as I said, you should have extensions enabled because it's more professional and file names just look better that way. So open it in your text editor of your choice, and mine is, as I said, Notepad++. And this may seem a little bit technical for you, but the only values I'm interested in are render underscore w, render underscore h, and winw and winh. So this means the window width and window height. Because I have a pretty small screen, I can only film it in 720. So this is a default resolution of 720p. So I set windows w and windows h and render w and render h to 1280 and 720 respectively. And these values and these values should be the same for best render quality. Now, after editing this file, go ahead and save it, and you can now close your text editor and you can launch the game finally. And I'm gonna launch it with our launch file, and the game is starting up. Okay, so I am in game now, and in game there will be a few settings you will want to set, and as you can see, my game is set to pretty high quality, and well, this may be different for you. You may not have a machine as powerful as I do, so you may want to tweak this to your liking, but the settings I use are these, and you may want to go to advanced settings for this one. I am using visibility around 3300, but I change this a lot depending on the needs of my scene. Texture detail very high, video memory default, anisotropic filtering very high, anti-aliasing low, but well, then again, I set this to the needs of my scene. ATOC is set to all trees plus grass. Terrain detail normal, objects detail very high, shadow detail very high, HDR quality normal, PPAA disabled, post-process effects very high, interface size, well, this doesn't matter at all, and aspect ratio, this depends on your aspect ratio, and VSync is disabled for me. Now, a little bit about these settings. You need to have a video memory set to default, because, well, your instinct might tell you to set this to very high, but you will not be using all the memory available for ArmA if you set this to very high, so just set video memory to default to use all the available video memory for your game. Texture detail is self-explanatory, and anisotropic filtering is a thing with your alpha textures, and without going too technical, it's a quality of far objects, so you can just see if I go to this road, and as you can see, it renders pretty nicely far away, but if I set my anisotropic filtering to disabled, you can see it starts getting blurry in the distance, so just set this to very high, and you can immediately see that the quality is getting a lot better. And anti-aliasing is the most demanding setting of the game, and you may want to disable this setting depending on your machine power, but if you crank all the settings to high and you're still getting decent FPS, you can start cranking up the anti-aliasing. Now, I don't really know what ATOC means, but it has something to do with trees and foliage, so if you disable this, you can immediately see these details on trees. They just look plain ugly with these ugly pixels and everything, and the forest just don't look full, and if you set all trees plus grass, you can immediately see everything, all the trees, all the grass, they just start looking a lot fuller. I like keeping terrain detail at normal because well, the differences are barely noticeable, and AI has difficulties moving on terrain other than normal, so normal terrain is the best bet, and it of course is a very demanding setting, and you just don't get too much from the setting, so just leave it at normal. Objects detail, well, of course that's self-explanatory. Shadow detail is also self-explanatory. HDR quality, well, you can set this to whatever you like. I like filming my footage at normal, but you may like to film this at very high. PPAA means post-process anti-aliasing, and well, this has to do with explosions and fire and everything. I like keeping this disabled because, well, it just doesn't seem to be very noticeable in the movie. Post-process effects are set to very high because this is responsible for all the blurs and lens flares and everything, and I heard people say that this is a very demanding setting, but I found that not to be true, and this setting actually does not influence my FPS at all. If you're playing the game, you may want to disable this because you can immediately see better and everything, but I like keeping this at very high because it just gives a smoother image and all the nice motion blurs and all the nice depth of field and everything. Interface size doesn't matter, aspect ratio doesn't matter, and VSync is sometimes called anti-epilepsy filter, and it is supposed to smooth the image on the screen, but I found that it just makes games seem sluggish and it's a very demanding setting, so you should always keep this at disabled. Please note that you may see a little bit of the lag and low FPS, but that doesn't really matter as long as you have 25 FPS or higher. You will find out later that FPS doesn't really matter in filming the videos in ArmA 2. So, your game should now be running in full potential and you are ready to start filming your own ArmA videos. I would like to remind you that if you found this video useful and entertaining, you should click the like button. That really helps and shows me that people are really interested in this kind of stuff. I will be uploading more videos like this from time to time, so if you want to stay updated, you should subscribe to my channel and you'll be the first to know. So anyway, thanks for watching the video. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask them in the comments, and I'll see you in the next video.